this week, but said he'd be ready to go when it counts. So, again, we're talking to Big Daddy Dale Hammer. We're live here at Food City and Gray. We're going to have the quiz show coming up here in a few minutes. So, you've been at this a long time. All these are great specials. Which one of those, as a guy that's been in the grocery business many, many, many years, which one jumps out at you, big guy?
The spiral sliced hams. That's a real good deal.
All right. And right here behind us, got the water and the bath tissue. And we've got Campbell soup on sale.
$3 right here for you.
Yep, absolutely. So, good stuff. And again, it starts at midnight. It starts at noon and goes to midnight, 35 minutes away. A lot of folks are already coming and getting their buggies and going around and shopping. So, by the time that the noon hour strikes, computers are set, registers are ready, and everything goes into effect, right?
We'll be ready to go.
There you go. Now, tell me about school bugs. It's something that you can help out with schools here in the Midnight Madness cell. Tell me all about. Hello, Snooker. How are you? Laura Fowler, longtime friend. She's a dandy. Used to coach the Dobbins Minute Lady Indians back in the day. School bugs. Tell me about school bugs, would you please?
School bugs. All you got to do is come in and attach your and stick your value card up to your local school. And your purchases will get points for your students. And then we'll give them a bunch of money come next spring.
Passed out checks. Give me some of the amounts of checks you passed out this year.
I passed out a few that was close to $2,000.
Awesome. They can use it any way they want. Any of the schools do. And so you can't go wrong with that. And when you can hand a check to a school and they can use it for anything they need, whether it's paper towels, microscopes, kickballs, lights, whatever they got to use it for, mulch for the playground equipment, you just say, here's the check. Thank you for being a part of the School Bucks program, right?
That's correct.
There you go.
They really like to see us come.
There you go. Absolutely. You kind of look like Santa Claus, I think. So, hello, Texas. All right. So, my man is here ready for the quiz show. Ben, let's hit the quiz show music, my friend. Here we go. This is going to be good because this is not going to go good for you today because I heard all that 5 for 5 I want to hear about. All right. True or false? Here we go. First question. Get your bell and buzzer ready. Mr. Ben Foy back in the home front. Pat Patterson is going to join us coming up here in just a few minutes. And so, hello, Texas. First Super Bowl played in 1966. Is that true or false? I'm feeling good already. Smokes are coming out of his ears. First Super Bowl played in 1966. Looking for the year. Is that true or false?
False.
Final answer?
Final answer.
God, ring the bell, Ben. It's 1967. Oh, gosh. All right, here we go. Next question, number two. True or false, there's never been a player go to 5 straight Super Bowls.
True.
Final answer?
Final answer.
Ben, hit the buzzer. Yeah. Gail Gilbert from 1991-1995, 4 years of Buffalo, 1 year of San Diego, 5 straight years he went to the Super Bowl. 1 for 2. Number 3, the San Diego Chargers have never won a Super Bowl. True or false? Hit the bell, Ben. 2 for 3. All right. Number 4, looking for the number. There's been 2 teams that have been to the Super Bowl 4 times and never won. Looking for the number 2. Is that true or false? There's been 2 teams been to the Super Bowl 4 times and never won. True or false? 2 teams.
False.
Final answer. Yeah. Hit that buzzer, Ben. There you go. Minnesota and Buffalo. All right. Last one. Can he finish strong? 2 for 4. Number 5. The team that has lost the most Super Bowls are the Buffalo Bills. False. Final answer. Hit the bell, Ben. He finishes above 500. The Denver Broncos. Well, it's the boys going. There you go. So, the Denver Broncos went 3 for 5. That's good. I feel better. So I'll probably never be back out here again. But frozen. We're back to Eggos in February. We're coming back to set us up in front of the frozen food section like we did last time. That's good. All right. when it gets crazy, it's going to get crazy in a few minutes. Can you come back one more time? You done?
I'll try to come back one more time.
I love for you to come back. Appreciate you very good, my friend. So tell him goodbye.
Goodbye.
All right. Thank the world of the boy. He's a good feller. We'll take a quick break, come right back, and as promised, we got Doug Fritz coming up here in a few minutes. In fact, he is here, and so we're going to talk to him next, and then we're going to work in between now and the top of the hour. We will hear from Pat Patterson of the Performance Racing Network about the format changes of NASCAR. Doug Fritz is here. I want to get him in here next, and he will do just that, as we're here live at Food City and Gray for the Midnight Madness Sale. Our dear friend Doug Fritz from the Johnson City Press joins us next year on AM 790 and also on Facebook Live. That was hilarious. My boy did not go good. He didn't like it either. That's all right. That'll teach him run that mouth. No. There you go. That's what I'm doing. I'm probably mine up the water. He's got some people down in Greene County listening, you reckon?
I do.
You give them a shout out.
I got my Sunday school class praying for me, and people down in Greenville listening. From the edge, you're listening, Greenville, y'all would guess.
So, I'd say they hear some awesome.
And then, got some of the his mom couldn't get it. She couldn't get it done. She worked for whatever reason. So, at least one of the kids was in the Facebook
Live. Awesome. Talk a little bit of sports, I guess, tonight. So you got Elizabeth and Sal.
I'm Taylor. We will miss you, DB, brother.
Well, thank you very much.
But I was around with my brother coaches here now, Jake Mullen.
Yeah. I appreciate that.
I missed you on the radio. You did a good job.
Well, thank you very much. It's very kind. Thank you. Yes, you can do that. I'll steal your thunder. And then have you talk about the Three Rivers, probably since you're over there covering all the time, and the audience, DB and Science, that'll be a good one tonight.
So which one was first?
You. Oh, yeah. It's a whole lot more important. 30 seconds. Back on the Tom Taylor Sports Show on Facebook Live, and of course on AM 790 across 20 counties across Tennessee, Virginia, North Carolina, and even in eastern Kentucky. And we say good morning to you. We are live at 28 before the hour, 34 degrees. Again, Ben said cold temperature. It's going to warm back up to the 50s by Tuesday. So just hunker down and shop at Food City. Get whatever you need to do to get us through the weekend. You're ready to go. Warm weather's coming back in the 50s by Tuesday. I like it. We are joined by a dear, dear friend. I'll tell you what, he and I think we haven't, but on my side of the fence, we've gotten very close, and I appreciate this young man very, very much. He is Doug Fritz from the Johnson City Press. We're going to talk a little Super Bowl in a few minutes and talk a little high school basketball, but Doug is here with another story and another situation, and pretty phenomenal. When he told me about it the other night, I literally pulled off the road. I was in Food City, as a matter of fact, in Boone's Creek getting gas, and I pulled off. I was just kind of taken back. So Doug's here. Good morning, sir. How you doing?
I'm doing really well.
A tough situation turned into a very positive situation. And if you have listened to the show, you will know I unashamedly start this show with a Bible verse. I'm all about promoting the Lord Jesus. This is his show. And so without him, I've had to learn the hard way down through the years. I am nothing. The sooner I figured out to put my hand in the hand with the man and let him drive the bus, it's a whole lot easier. And so as a result of that, Doug and I have struck up a friendship beyond sports and, from a spiritual Christian-to-Christian standpoint. So setting this up, went through a tough situation, he and his wife, and yet the Lord's hand was all over this. So without further ado, tell us again what happened and how it happened just this week. And folks, if you're out there listening, and before I let him get started here, you're just going to hear that the Lord's hand is in everybody's life. The sooner you figure it out, the better. And so we serve a great big God. So take it away, big God. Tell us what happened.
Well, first of all, I want to say there's some people praying for me. I didn't want to try and do this on my own without the support of my brothers. Sunday school class at Calvary Baptist in Irwin. A lot of very good men in there who know the Lord and love the Lord. And David Crutchfield's a preacher there, and he preaches straight from the Bible, and I have a great deal of respect for him. But Sunday morning, I went to church. Went to Sunday school, went to church, and was driving home, and got a call from Loretta's uncle, and he told me that Loretta's dad had passed away.
Now, Loretta's your wife.
Loretta's okay. My wife.
Yes, yeah. Sir. Okay. Go ahead.
And told me Loretta's dad had passed away, and I had to drive home and tell Loretta it was her birthday.
Wow.
But she was sick in bed, and when I got home, wasn't anything going on in the house. I knew she was probably upstairs still in bed. I got up there, she was still asleep. And, had difficulty finding the words to tell her, and told her, and she immediately just broke down. And I told her, I said, told her later, I said, Loretta, I knew you loved your dad, but until I saw your reaction to the news, I didn't really know how much you loved your dad.
Mm-hmm.
And then the story started unfolding when we found out the details of it.
Incredible.
Leonard Herschel Bradley was in church. He got up and shared a testimony about some things that were going on in his life and some difficult things with home insurance, where they were canceling his home insurance. And he said, you know, he said, I think that they're just doing this because they know that they're not going to get much more money out of me. Kind of foreshadowing what was about to happen. And everybody in the family believes he knew what was going to happen that morning. He had told his wife, normally says a certain thing to her, but he said it a little differently this morning before he left for church. So he got up in front of the church, and the pastor, Adam Gaddis, I think, played along with him, but Leonard played, and I wrote down the name of the song, just to make sure I get it right, Rise Up, because I have it with me, but Rise Up, Children, Go Home, or Rise Up, Children, Come Home. Sorry, I can't remember the exact name of the song, but he played on the guitar and he sang, and Adam, the pastor, said he sang without didn't miss a beat, wasn't off key, didn't struggle with his breathing, and just sang it beautifully and just praised the Lord with his song. And Adam turned around to get back up to the pulpit, and in the process of doing that, somebody got his attention and lived, had died.
Set his guitar down.
Set his guitar down. Everything's praising the Lord. So in his last breath, and he had chopped wood the day before. So he lived a full, how many 85-year-old men are out chopping wood on Saturday?
Exactly.
How many 85-year-old men are physically able to drive themselves to church? How many 85-year-old men are able to play guitar and sing praise to the Lord?
Absolutely. At age? Not many.
How many of them lived at 85? And there he was at this last breath on earth, praising the Lord, and his next breath he's in heaven and praising the Lord the whole day of play.
So he sang a song, put his guitar down, and the Lord took him home right there in the pulpit.
So that's not the end of the
story's not over, no. It's like Paul Harvey. That's not the end of the story, okay? It really gets good.
And let me tell you about Leonard. I've only known him for 4 years, I guess. As long as Loretta and I've been married, just a little over 4 years. I've described him one way, a great man of faith. I would go to his house. We didn't get very many opportunities to go down there, but Loretta has health issues, and would say, yes, you struggle with this, will you pray for her? And he wouldn't say, okay, I'll pray for him. He'd stop.
Right there.
Gather us in a circle. We'd hold hands together, and he would just pray in the Spirit as the Lord was leading him. And you would hear the words, and you would feel the sincerity. You would feel his belief. You would feel, you know, how close he was to the Lord. And this is just a man who, like I said, I knew for 4 years, but I had a great deal of respect for him and that small amount of bits and pieces that I knew him. And so you can imagine the impact once he passed away at the funeral home when they were having the visitation. His grandson, Jake, is 14 years old. My granddaughter, Emily, 11 years old, accepted Jesus as our Savior at the funeral home last night. Jacob, Loretta was telling me, Jacob said, I just can't quit smiling. And then at the funeral service on, I guess it's Thursday, yesterday, I'm putting it together here, two more people raised their hand and rededicated or either rededicated or accepted Jesus, whatever the case was for their individual situation. And then, you know, here today, Leonard's story is going out to however many people are listening all out of Northeast Tennessee, and his fire down here is burning, because when you leave this world, when you love the Lord, you leave this world, it's just not like poop and it's gone. There's a continuous down there. There's still something down here if you love the Lord and show it that way.
We're talking to Fritz from the Johnson City Press, sports writer who's blew me away, and I hope he's blown you away too. What a story. This gentleman falls over after singing, goes into glory, and already four people have either accepted the Lord or rededicated their lives, because of this gentleman. And as a result of that, here he is. We're talking about him across 20 counties here across the region. And of course, we're on Facebook Live, and as we said earlier, we had 6,000 views on Wednesday's shows. There's no telling who's seeing this, who's going to be able to go back and hear it and see it. So that's how he works. He's a connect the dot God. And so a negative or a sad situation with the family, certainly, and they can rejoice, obviously, knowing that this gentleman had the impact that he did, and it's still having an impact. And he's in glory looking down, grinning, probably like a fox in a hen house right now, saying, "You boys go there in Food City and talk about the Lord." And so because of Leonard, folks' lives are being changed, and I dare say we're not at the end of that. They'll continue to be changed, wouldn't you think?
Yeah, and you think about it, too, because here you are, but this is a sports show, and we're taking this time out because of the way that the Lord works in Leonard's life. And, you know, the thing about it is, too, you know, as I've grown older and grown wiser because of what the Lord's done for me, and I've understood that, and I still enjoy sports. I enjoy watching the football games. Loretta will tell people probably enjoy it a little bit more than I should. Get a little bit too frustrated, aggravated with it. But what I truly do understand is there's no sporting game, there's no sport that's going to matter in the realm of eternity. I mean, we can play sports and do sports and talk about sports in a way that's, that we're doing it the way we're enjoying it, we're enjoying life and so forth. But what really matters at the end of the day is, what are we doing for eternity? If we're not helping somebody for eternity, if we're not leading somebody to eternity, if we're not, my great, great friend George Young passed away 2 years ago. He said several times to me, and tell me again, and I always enjoy hearing him say, what's better than going to heaven? And the first time he told me, I went, what are you talking about? Nothing's better than going to heaven. He said, yeah, taking somebody with you. And, that's what we're here for. We're here to proclaim the name of Jesus Christ. We're here to point others to Him. We're here to share the gospel that Jesus died, He was raised on the third day, and He did that, gave His life for us so that we may have eternal life. And that is the most important thing. And that's really, when you get down to the end of the day, that's the only thing.
You got it. We all have one question we have to answer, folks, and I've told you this many times on the show, and it's true, and Doug just said it. One question we all have to answer, one way or the other. What are you going to do with Jesus? You're either going to reject Him or accept Him. Just that simple. And so, you don't want to hear it, I'm sorry, but that's what it is. That's what we all have to deal with. And Leonard accepted Him, sang to the last breath he drew on the earth, was singing for the Lord, set his guitar down, and I'm sure the Lord said, "Well done, my good and faithful servant, come on in." And so four have already had life-changing decisions made, and as I said, I dare say there'll be more before it's all said and done. So great story, and I said, "Doug, you got to come tell us about this." And I know it's tough for Loretta and all the family because they've lost someone they dearly love, but they can take great solace and comfort in knowing that, the impact is there. And because of Doug Fritz and our friendship, we got to tell this story across the airways, and hopefully a lot of people have heard it and will continue to hear it as they get back on Facebook and watch the show. So
I'll tell you too, Tom, I believe God worked that out in advance. He brought me into this situation, come here and talk about sports for a few months because he knew what was coming down the road, and he set this up, put this plan in motion. I believe that God works into the tiny details of life, and that's a great comfort. There's bad things that happen, and even in the bad things that happen, such as this, we know that all things work together for good for those who
love the Lord,
those who believe, and that's just another evidence of that, a difficult situation. And it's just an amazing thing when you see how the Lord works, and you see the way these things come together in a way that you couldn't even fathom or imagine.
It says in Isaiah, my ways, not your ways. Things I'm going to do you don't know about, you're not going to figure it out, I don't want to figure it out, and you're not going to figure it out, so don't try. So, and as we say on the show too, is that, you know, sports is one spoke in the wheel of life, and some folks may get the wheel of life. It's all, I mean, they just get all worked up over it, and I get that to a point, but at the end of the day, you know, I'm a big Raiders fan, and so if this old heart stops beating, I'm not going to ask how many times I like the Raiders or how many ball games I did on, you know, on the radio, or how many of this I've done or how many of that I've done. The question will be asked, as it will be asked of all of us, what have you done with the talents I gave you to further my kingdom? That's pretty much how it's going to be. So we furthered it today, my friend. Our talking to our buddy Doug Fitch. Do you want to talk sports? Do you just want to skip and come back next week? It's up to you.
It's up to you. I can sit here for a few more minutes if you want me to. I'm just thrilled. I'm so thankful to Tom for your testimony, which is someone who will take time, you know, for something like this. And I know that you lifted Loretta's spirits when you told her that you were doing this, you know, because, I mean, this is your show. This is your thing. This is about sports. You love the Lord, and I appreciate your time, and I appreciate you taking time, and these minutes and seconds are more valuable, you know, to me, and I hope that they're valuable to somebody who will hear this, and maybe, you know, maybe they'll sit down and reevaluate their lives, and maybe they confess Jesus as their Savior. Maybe they're a believer, but then their life has gone off on the path that they've gotten drawn away from God. Not that they've lost their salvation, because I don't believe you can do that, but you can get on the wrong path, and maybe somebody just needs to rededicate their life to Jesus. And my wife did that several years ago before I met her, and had she not done that, I don't believe I would have met her, and I believe that was part of the Lord's plan for her.
I say it all the time, my friend. He's a connected dot God. He's moving. He's like a plant checkers. He's always moving pieces around, putting people here, and having this person cross somebody's path, and so on and so forth. So it's how he operates, and he's a great big God, and he's awesome, and we can't thank him enough. I guess I will ask a couple of sports questions, and I'm going to let you go. We got Pat Patterson going to join us again, coming up with the Performance Racing Network, all these NASCAR format changes, but high school basketball, you're covering it locally for the John City Press, obviously, and Three Rivers Conference, that's a heck of a conference race right now. And well, who's Elizabethan, Sullivan East, and Unicoi County, they're kind of in Happy Valley's in there duking it out. So it's you said early on when we first started talking hoops a couple of months ago, it's going to be a great race, and it really has been, hasn't it?
Boy, it really has, and you know, Sullivan East got Unicoi again the other night, so they got two up on Unicoi, and Unicoi's had some adversity that they're dealing with and trying to mold pieces back into place there. Elizabethan's looking really strong, and I'm really looking forward to that rematch between Elizabethan and Sullivan East. Sullivan East got Cole Green back. I don't know what kind of an impact he's going to have right away. You know, knee injuries are a tough thing to overcome. I've counted out, I think it's been about 6 months on him. But if he gets back anywhere near the old Cole Green comes early tonight, that's going to be an awesome side with the battle. So two really good teams. One of those two teams can go to shot down the road. I don't think both of them do. Similar to a two on the road. If they make it to the sectional round, which, you know, Granger will have something to say about that. Granger will have a lot of good stuff to look forward to.
Last question, I'll let you go. I got Pat Patterson coming here in just a few minutes, and I'll check in with him from Performance Racing Network. Super Bowl, Falcons or Patriots? Falcons got anything in the tank for the Patriots?
I need to duck one thing in here real quick. Yanaka's new football guy.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, go ahead.
Young man named O'Brien Bennett, Dobbins Bennett graduate.
Yeah.
Graduated in 2001. Been coaching down in Knoxville, was a Carter from 2007 to 2012. Moved over to Knox Hall, which is where my younger brother is assistant baseball coach and coach and played under Doug Holston there. Knox Hall for O'Brien Bennett was part of that Hall's program of football that became from the first round of 5A playoffs this past season. Lost the cup of the Morristown West. He's coming up to take over the Unique football program. And, you know, get a DB out Unique. And that says also what the tradition DB's had, so maybe Unique's got better things to do.
That's two guys at Graham Clark. Gerald Sensabaugh down at Crockett, and now O'Brien Bennett up at Unique that have played under Graham Clark, and because of his influence and the success of the program at DB, went on to be coaches. That's pretty cool.
And as for the Super Bowl, you know, conventional wisdom and the way you look at this thing and New England with their history and tradition and so forth, you know, it's hard to figure out this Tom Brady. It's hard to figure out this New England. But I saw another thing that just caught a glimpse of it online. It says New England's four Super Bowl victories come from a combined total of 13 points. Now, again, I just caught, I think that's accurate. Thank you. So even, and then they've lost a couple of times. So I don't expect them to go in there and dominate Atlanta. The way the offense is too good, I think Atlanta's got a shot. I'll go out on a limb and I'll go with the Falcons because I really like their offense. And I give more credit to their defense than most people do. I think they've got an improving defense. I think they've got a defense that can make plays at key times and really come through. And so I'm going to go with the Falcons.
Falcons, that's who I'm going for. Speed. I used to say speed, Andy. I mean, you got Freeman back there, Coleman, Julio Jones, Gabriel, Austin. Hooper. Austin Hooper as a wideout. I mean, these guys can go Sanu. They said at the same time, Sanu. I mean, the Falcons have got speed. What an offense. And so the defense not too slouch either. I'm taking the Falcons to beat the Patriots next week. Plus, I'm a Southern boy, so it's kind of a Southern thing, too. But just on the field, it's going to be it should be a great showdown. Doug Fritz, very tough for you to come talk about this today, my friend. I know Loretta, and I mean, when you lose a family member, it's tough to talk about. But you did it with class and grace and style as only you can. And so appreciate you and Miss Loretta. And I'm proud to call you my friend, Bubba. So.
It's a good day, and it's wind's blowing, it's cold, it's spitting snow out there, but I've been able to miss this for the world, but I'm just thankful the Lord for giving me this opportunity to come and talk about him. That's my favorite subject, and that's what when I write songs and play guitar, and most of the time I'm singing about the Lord, I try to write in a way that's pleasing to him, and I'm just thankful.
There you go. Thank you, my friend. Give me some taters. That's my man, Doug Fritz. Again, the question will be asked by all of us, my friend. What are we going to do with Jesus? That's what just comes down to that. And it's real simple. Quick break. We'll be right back. We've got her right here, Miss Tammy. We're going to talk about the Midnight Madness sale. And then, as promised, Pat Patterson joins us from the Performance Racing Network. We're live again. We appreciate you very much. We're live here at Food City in Gray. Midnight Madness sale. We're starting it in 7 minutes. And it's going to go to midnight tonight. Folks are already in here with their buggy shopping and getting these specials. Once the clock strikes high noon, all the computers kick in and sale prices go into effect. And so we'll come back and talk more about that. Quick break. We'll be right back. We're live here at Food City in Gray on the Tom Taylor Sports Show. Yes. Oh, is Doug still there? Yeah, he wants to tell you something.
Ready?
No. Go ahead.
Ready?
Mike is a college grad. A college student is all that.
You're welcome. Thank you. I appreciate y'all for the opportunity. I turned on the radio this morning from the Reddit, and I don't know what was on there, but some form of religious program, and I think comment on the golf, and I'm like, yeah, that's a... I appreciate y'all for your all's love and support to be able to work in a place where you can be back.
Yep.
Amen.
Yep. And go as far as he wants it to go. So, yeah. What other radio station? I bet you not too many other stations allow you to come on and talk about the Lord.
They wouldn't let me talk that long. They cut me off and get me on some different subject really quick. Okay.
What are you going to do with Jesus? That's the key, my friend. So, and I appreciate you. And I'm, you know, again, I hope you put a smile on everybody's face and do it. Because that was a good way to honor the young man. So, young feller, as they say. So, enjoy your weekend, big dog. Yep. He's a jewel right there, and I took guts to do that. So we go from the beast to the beast. I've got Tammy right here. I'm going to let her get on it real quick. She don't want to talk long. She won't have to. Come right here, doll, baby. We'll let you slide in here and talk a little Midnight Madness, and we're going to take another break and go to Pat Patterson. And we're back live at Food City and Grail, the Tom Taylor Sports Show again. Spiral sliced ham, 99 cents a pound. Red Sealess grapes, 99 cents a pound. Some of the specials. Again, right behind us, we got the Scott bath tissue and Scott paper towels, $3.99. That's at all Food Cities. We're here at Food City and Grail. Coming up in a few minutes, Pat Patterson will join us from the Performance Racing Network. There she is on Facebook, our buddy Miss Tammy. And what kind of specials you got, dear?
Oh, in the floral department today, we have our mini trees for $7.99. Lavender ice bouquets for $8.99, our oopsie daisies for $5.99, and we also have a special on bamboo plants for $4.99, and they grow for $9.99, so that's half price off on those.
What is a money tree? I may want to get about four or five of those if there's money growing on them. What is a money tree, dear?
It is a tree that stands, I don't know, about 7 inches high, and it's braided together, and it has a real nice foliage on top, and they say it brings good luck to bring money into the home.
So it's not like a ficus tree, it's tabletop, right?
Yes.
Okay, tabletop tree, good. And then the ice lavender bouquet.
Yeah, and it has all kinds of different stuff in it. It has like carnations and palms and little buttons, as I call them, and astromelia lilies. It's a real good deal for $8.99.
And then I call these the doghouse bouquet, but if you get in the doghouse, guys or ladies, you know, guys like flowers too. It sounds silly, but I know I like flowers. So if you get in trouble and you need to get out of the doghouse, the oopsie daisy bouquet. Tell me about that one.
The oopsie daisy bouquet is a bright, colorful little bouquet for $5.99. We usually try to keep it in house, and it usually runs about $7.99. But we have it on special this week for $5.99.
Now, Midnight Madness Day, Valentine's Day, right around the corner. I've already told Dale up there I want one of those gizmos up there. One of those, what do you call? Candy bouquets?
Yeah, that's a dozen candy bouquet. It runs for $36.99. It has 12 candy bars in it. And it takes quite a lot to put those together, but they're really nice once they're together.
I dropped a major hint. Adele liked to have that for Valentine's Day. He walked off.
Yeah.
I said, what about chocolate dipped strawberries? Walked off. So.
Hey, we're now on chocolate dipped strawberries. The floral department's hooking up with the Bakery Deli. And for $29.99, you can get chocolate covered strawberries with a dozen roses in the sleeve. That's a great deal.
It's not that far away, Valentine's Day. And you know this, I'm going to preach it before we let you go. Don't procrastinate. Don't walk in here day of. When you can do it, you can pull it off for them, but it's better to come in and pre-order, and that way it's already taken care of, right?
Well, it's not only taken care of, and I'll take care of anybody the best way I can, but if you pre-order, then you're guaranteed basically to get exactly what you want.
Exactly.
It's not thrown together in a rush. We have time to work on it. And in that way, you're getting quality for your money.
There you go. Getting the bang for the buck. So
that's it.
When you see Dale back there in a minute, our store manager, you say, Dale, get Tom up. Get Tom up. What do you call those things?
A candy bouquet.
Get Tom a candy.
I also have those in sixes, too. They come in half dozen the same as those.
I'll take six. Just say, Tom, get him a Mr. Good Bar bouquet, please.
I can do that.
He looks so pitiful over at that table. Help him out. How long you been at Food City?
I've been at Food City going on 13 years.
Yeah, this lady is one of the coolest ladies ever. Every time I come in here, she's always got that smile. I don't care what kind of day she's having. You would think she's on top of the world, and most of the time she is. But even on the bad day, she's always smiling. I appreciate that about you. You always have.
Well, I enjoy my customers. This is what we're here for. It's the reason I work for Food City, because we're customer-oriented. And, you know, these people that come in here, you never know what kind of day they're having if they come in from the doctor's office or something, and they deserve a smile.
There you go. You know?
And I just really enjoy my job here.
There you go. And you're doing well.
Yeah, I work for some great people.
What about Dale?
Oh, yeah, he's my hero.
Dale's everybody's hero. There you go. Thank you, dear. You're
thank
awesome.
You.
Yeah, she's a sweetheart. That's our buddy Tammy again from right here. And we appreciate her very much. And so, again, love coming in and promoting Food City every chance we get. The Midnight Madness sale has begun. Quick break. As promised, Pat Patterson joins us next from the Performance Racing Network. What in the world's going on with NASCAR? They'll tell us after this quick 60-second break. We'll go right back to Pat Patterson and see what's going on with NASCAR 2017 here on the Tom Taylor Sports Show. About 20-1.
Mm-hmm.
About 20-1. I got them stocked up. You can come back at 20-1. I'll put you okay. And because I'll slide you right in. What are you gonna talk about, Baker Dell? Yeah. Cause I got an interview I gotta play now. But if you'll come back in, I'll be ready for you.
Okay.
I promise. Thank you, dear. Miss Phelps. Just go straight to Pat, yeah.
It's crazy out there.
It's what? Midnight Madness, yeah.
I know, I just...
Hello, Darlene. Watching, eating some tater soup and watching the meal. Thank you very much. That's sweet of you. Lady Symphony said she having some good potato soup for lunch. And all he needs is a grilled cheese sandwich. Go with that now. You like grilled cheese?
I like grilled cheese.
Yeah. How are you?
Good.
Yeah, just roll as fast and go get back into it, my friend, because I got two more guests I got to get in before, and Danica and Austin. So, you want to hit it right after this? That'd be great. How's community chess going? Good. Still working
right
with, still working with Dale.
No. Don't have a whole lot of choice. It could be worse.
It could be worse.
It could be worse.
Is he back?
Hey Dale, he's talking about you on the radio. You got that guy.
Gonna snow.
Hey.
Heard it right here.
Heard it right here at Feed City.
You
get your milk and eggs and taters.
And we got two bread trucks waiting.
Three bread.
Right.
Grapes, ham, oatmeal, crackers. Hey. Get it.
See y'all. See.
Keep smiling, Bubba.
All right. You do the same. See
you. Oh, okay. Nice to meet you.
We're talking about sports tourism, about all these ball tournaments coming in here, all that money.
Big race coming, too.
Food City 25th anniversary. Can't wait.
Second longest sponsor in NASCAR, Coca-Cola.
Yep. Yep.
They're going to do something last week in Sevierville, too. They're doing a border ball or something.
Yeah, they did a border, the football, all-star football game, the border ball.
We're in everything on demand.
That's what you want.
It's always good. I got to go to Knoxville.
That's why they, people tell me all the time, like, is because you give back to the community. I hear that all the time.
You live out this way?
live in Fort Johnson City. You know where Mahoney's is? Live near Mahoney's.
I built a house just down the street here.
I heard.
I got by the airport. Yeah.
So you going to K-Town today?
Wally gagging a little bit. My wife kind of pushed them on to go with me. Wait until about 1 o'clock. Chest beats things up.
Here you go.
Yeah, wait on her. I got to go get her and we're going to Knox. Our son actually lives down there now. He's wrapping up. He's at ETSU Pharmacy School. His second half of the year, he's going to rotate to Knox. He's got a park up there in town, so I'll drop her off and get the place.
The little guy used to bring, when you come by those remotes when I was in Kingsport, he's in college.
He's finished college. He's finished UP and he's at ETSU now. He's getting married in September. You know Rick Russo, BLT?
Yeah.
I'm marrying Rick's daughter.
Fort really?
Scott, yeah. Now, well, my daughter's finished. She graduated UTC and she's in med school. She's over at LMU.
You're getting old. I remember he bringing the remote. I never met your daughter. He brought the little guy. He was about grade school.
Yeah, Brianna's, she's over at, she got her degree in biochemistry down at Chattanooga when she came to LMU. She actually just got accepted to do a research project for the summer at Apple, Hospital Apple, at Johnson Memorial. So she's going to stay with us this summer. Which tickled me. She had a little help here to research at Abby. So we got two connections up there. So.
I'd say, yeah. I'd say, yeah.
We worked on that one a little bit.
Made a phone call or two. Now, is Mama glad she's come back this summer, too?
Yeah.
All right. I know Daddy's do that. He's Daddy's little girl.
So,
I love coming out here and doing this because it's like, I just had Tammy on. See, I get the associates on. I get them all. I had Dale on early and did trivia, Super Bowl trivia.
You must have him on the radio talking about somebody kissing him or something.
Yeah.
A day or two ago, this lady stopped him in the aisle and they're talking to him about it. She heard it on the radio.
I embarrass him every chance I get. And of course, he's already talking about the sale. We're going to push it some more. But, yep, Kevin's
you're
got
Washington County?
I'm with Northeast Tennessee, so I come to the 8th.
She took Claudia Moody's class. Remember Claudia?
Where do you work out
at? I'm in the University of Belmont.
Remember Claudia? Was it Claudia Moody? Whatever her name?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, Claudia. She retired, took her place.
I'm only been back after a couple of years. I've been in Knox since I was born. So. My brother wrote this place right across the street. Jeff, President City.
That's your brother? I didn't know that.
My younger brother. He was Jack, our president, Knox City.
Yeah, well, he's married to the
Melissa
Stigall Jones.
Huh?
Jeff's your brother?
Yeah.
I did not know
yeah,
that.
Yeah, we're just 2 years between us.
I never knew that.
Oh, yeah.
All these years I've known you.
Yeah.
I'll be doggone.
Yeah. Yeah, he runs the city up here.
But that's fun working across the street with each other.
Well, I don't work here. I work in the office. I'm just floating through.
Yeah.
I work up in Abington, so. We talk about it, but I don't see the whole lot.
I never knew that.
Yeah.
Wow.
He's been over there. I started at Food City when I was in high school. I've been here 37 years. So we grew up up next to Rhone Mountain.
You grew up in Rhone Mountain?
That's where we're from, up above Hampton. Went to Rhone Mountain.
I didn't know that.
And Jeff went to work at City when he was in college, right out of high school. And back then it was probably SPS or Dean Witter or whatever one of the names back then. But he went to work there. I went to work at Food City. A few years later, he went to work there. We've both been the whole time.
Career guys, both
yeah,
places.
Yeah, I've been here 37, and I think he's probably been there 30 plus. I'm not sure. He's a couple years younger than I am. He started 2 years later, but I got to think he's got 30, 32 years over there probably.
So you went to Hampton?
I went to Hampton. Jeff was City Fire. He went to Hampton. A couple years ago, he was a
oh, Hampton Bulldog.
Yeah, Jeff bailed out on me. He went to Elizabeth. But he drove to Elizabeth his junior and senior year. So he graduated from Elizabeth. Both went to the he's stayed pretty close here. No, I take that back. He actually went to Chicago and played for a year or two with City. That's being Sears, whoever they were then. And then I've been to all over the place. I've been at Fort, Knoxville, Bristol, Elizabeth, Chattanooga. I've been everywhere.
But you're back here now. This is it?
built the house, I can try. If Steve moves me, I'll get a condo or something. I'm too old for that crap. That was a point where you just over it. We moved 10 times.
10 times?
We've been married 30 years.
How many years have you been married?
30.
So every 3 years on the average, you're moving. She's probably said no more, too, right? Speaking of.
There he comes.
There he is.
Pretty strange. Good, how are you?
Strawberry's been coming soon on the bank. Sandy Banks, the no jockey. Remember that time?
Yeah. Not strawberry.
On the sand.
You didn't know Jeff was my brother.
I did not know that. All these years I know you. Who's older?
I'm 2 years older. I'm 53.
See, I know his sister-in-law, not Melissa, but the sister.
Melanie.
Yeah, Melanie. From the chamber.
She's at the hospital, I believe, from City. And her husband, let's see. He was an IT guy at the hospital, but I think he's carrying. I'm trying to think his name.
She's still there, yeah. Mountain States, but he, I don't know. He's doing something different. But,
yeah. They got the set of twins. I don't know.
Yeah, they do. And,
what's on top of your phone?
Microphone.
Oh, is that what that is? Really?
I do this along with the radio.
Yeah.
Wednesdays.
It's live.
It's live right now. Everything we're saying is live.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so I can't pick the note or anything like that. But Wednesday, I do a show every Wednesday at Chick-fil-A. We got 6,000 views. It averages about 1,800, 2,000. So, everyone doing live right here, looking at Miss Phelps. Look over at John. Is he on? Is he on the camera? Are you on? There's John Jones, Executive Vice President of Food City. One of the good guys. Known him for. It's, yeah, John says it'll snow. Come get your bread, your milk, your eggs, your hot cocoa, your Lipton tea, your bath towels, your instant oatmeal on the Midnight Madness sale. And then there's my hero, Dale Hammond, right there. There you go. My hero, Big Daddy Dale.
Good seeing you.
Hey, thank you. Thank you for letting me come out and do this. It's awesome.
Enjoy.
Thank you.
See you, Dale.
Drive careful. Good folks, people. Good peeps. So, he said, be sure and tell them it's going to snow. There you go. Well, I'm joined. We've got an interview going on right now on the radio side. Again, we're going to fix this very, very soon. We're both as meshed together, so you're hearing us right now. But on the radio station, you're hearing Pat Patterson from the Performance Racing Network. But coming up in just a few minutes, we'll hear from this young lady talking about sports tourism here in the region. That would be Alicia Phelps, Executive Director of the Northeast Tennessee Tourism Association, better known as NETA. So we will have her on here momentarily. And Darlene says she's going to come by after work and take advantage of some of the great deals at Food City, and we appreciate that. I guess I could be reading these while we're kind of breaking the action here. And we'll do that. Here are some of the specials again at Food City today. Till midnight tonight, red seedless grapes are 99 cents a pound. Spiral sliced whole or half Food City spiral sliced ham, 99 cents a pound. Stouffer's frozen entrees, six of those bad boys, $10 today and today only. Food Club hot cocoa, probably going to be good this weekend, 99 cents a box, limit four. Also, the produce department, fresh red or golden delicious apples, 3 pound bag for $1.99. Also, Ritz crackers, limit four boxes, $1.99. Also, Food City, this is going on until midnight tonight because it's on and running now. Vanilla wafers. You like vanilla wafers? I thought you told me that one time. I did. $1.99 a box, limit four. Sara Lee bread, whole grain white bread. Sara Lee, $1.99, limit two. Also, Starkist chunk-like tuna in a pouch, limit 10 for 79 cents. You like tuna? Well, not a tuna guy either. I'm right there with you. I bet a lot of people like it. And so, Starkist tuna for a pouch for 79 cents. Limit 10. Mayfield ice cream. I'm all about that. Mayfield novelties, 6-pack. Brown cow, fudge bars, all the Mayfield novelties for $1.49. Limit 4 boxes. And that's today till midnight tonight while supplies last. Those are some of the specials for the Midnight Madness sale. 34 degrees outside. We're going to come back here in just a few minutes and hang some more with Alicia Phelps. And also we're going to hear, yet to hear from Danny Patrick and Austin Dillon, NASCAR Monster Energy Cup Series drivers. And then also we will hear from David Crum, Tennessee Wildlife Resource Agency officer. And again, our buddy coming up here next would be the lovely Alicia Phelps. So just hang with us. We're about done with the interview. We'll be ready to go here in just a few minutes. Mr. Ben, how much time on the interview? About 7 or 8 minutes? 4 minutes. All right. Put that up here where you can hear that. Oh, yeah. Oh, absolutely. Well, Jasmine. No, ask him. You can embarrass me. Do I know what the topic's going to be? Or is it
football?
NFL football. All right. So, might as well get the quiz show theme ready. It looks like I'm going to get asked this time. So, yeah. So, they got the Bulls tonight. My Spurs are playing pretty good, even though Duncan's retired. It's all good. So,
I think we may be the only
one. Probably. You know, I'm pretty confident the only one in the Tri-Cities like the Heat. I probably like the Spurs.
Yeah, when I went to Miami, I went into the Spurs. And, you know, I think
the fans in Tennessee,
I'm like,
who fought
me?
Yeah, it's all matters, right? So, I went into the place here in the mall. They've got ball caps. I said, you guys got any Spurs caps? He said, this was his response. Why? I said, oh, okay, never mind. Yeah. So, but actually, I went back. They actually went and got one. I didn't tell them to, but they got a Spurs cap. Good. So, it's all good. It is amazing to sit here and watch the crowd come through here. Oh, yeah. I understand that. So,
and it's snowing.
Yeah, it's flurrying. Throw back to me while I've got her, and then you can just do a full break coming up. Please, just hit the bumper. And how's the sound quality? Is it good? Yeah. And I did something different on Bob's interview, too. It sounded better today, too. My interview with him, so I fixed it on. So, no, it really did. Yeah. That was very tough for Doug to come in and talk about that. So, don't touch me. Touch me again, I'm going to stomp. Touch me. I want a Mr. Goodbar bouquet from Dale Hammett.
How about today?
Yeah, just hit a bumper. Let's get this lovely lady on. I'm going to call you.
I got cold just now because the doors aren't closing because people are constantly coming.
Here, man, take your glove off and have your hand.
Will we hold hands?
Yeah, really. Laugh at me sitting in front of frozen waffles. No, I'm just holding your hand. Sure, I am proposing. Here you go. Will you be my friend?
Okay.
There you go. Her little hands.
There's a draft.
It is a little drafty. Will you?
Yeah.
There you are. We're in. Thanks again to Pat Patterson. Again, we're 30 days out for the Daytona 500. We're joined by Alicia Phelps. Again, we're here at Food City in Gray. And She said, it's getting cold in here. That's because the doors are flying open because there's a lot of folks in here shopping at Food City for the Midnight Madness sale. Again, as Dale said, that spiral sliced ham, whole or half, 99 cents a pound. That's a no-brainer. The red seedless grapes, 99 cents a pound. The Holly Farms boneless chicken breast family pack, $1.69 a pound. That is a no-brainer. These are all no-brainers. Really good to midnight. Supplies last. The Stouffer's entrees, 6 for $10 at your local Food City out of the 106 stores. And by the way, just had a great conversation with John Jones, the executive vice president. I can't remember, he's either second or third in command of the whole kit and caboodle. And you wouldn't find a nicer guy. You wouldn't find a nicer guy anywhere than John Jones, the executive vice president of Food City. Great guy. And again, I appreciate him very much. As a man, I love coming to these stores and promoting the associates and what all is going on. And he said, we love having you. So thank you, John. I know he's on his way down the road traveling. So also Food Club shredded cheese, 2 per shopper. A limit 2 for $4.99. Fritos or Cheetos. You like Fritos or Cheetos? You're a Fritos girl? Yeah. You're a Cheetos girl. There you go. Limit 4 today for $1.79. As she's here with us, she is our buddy Alicia Phelps from the Northeast Tennessee Tourism Association. Let's get her on camera. You're tired of seeing me. This will be the beast and the beauty. There she is. And so appreciate her very much. Now, matters in hand. You love Miami Heat. How are they doing right now?
Well, they're on, I think it's a 5-game winning streak right now. But tonight they play the Bulls, so we shall see.
All right. And so who's their big star? Wade's gone. Bosch is gone.
Well, they've got Waiters right now. Wade. But I really like Taylor Johnson, too. And, you know, you can't go wrong with Whiteside either. So it's a young team.
Who's the dude we used to make, I used to make fun of, had his hair look like a...
Don't make fun of him because you know he's my number one. He's out. He went to Cleveland.
He's gone.
He went to Memphis, then he went to Cleveland. He tore a ligament in his knee about a month ago, so he is out for the season. Chris Anderson.
Yeah. What was his nickname? Birdman?
Birdman,
yeah.
Got a little figure of him.
I'm sorry to hear that. So, Birdman.
That's probably it for him. He's about 37, so.
Did you still have his hair spike?
No.
Tamed it down a little bit?
He did tame it down, but he does have this long beard that I'm not a fan of.
Not a fan of. Doesn't do it. Doesn't work. All right. So, there we go. We took care of that, the Miami Heat. And so, she is the executive director of the Northeast Tennessee Tourism Association, which covers how many counties?
Eight
counties here in Northeast Tennessee. Last time we had you on, and you're right, there's something going on every weekend. Even here in January, there's always something going on around here. It's for tourism, and I guess, you know, what I want to talk about for a few minutes today is this sports tourism.
Yeah.
I don't think folks realize what kind of money generated for our cities and our retail folks with sports tourism.
Yeah, so when we talk about sports tourism, we're not... You know, of course there's NASCAR. I consider that a sport, and I hope everybody does.
Sure.
But we're also talking about, like, AAU tournaments, swimming tournaments, cheerleading, you know, stuff that the kids are in middle school, high school, and college as well. So Kingsport and Johnson City and Bristol and Greenville, they bring in tennis and golf in Greenville, but they do a really good job. And we have to remember that keeps us going in these cold blood. So coming up in Kingsport this weekend is the Polar Bear Swim Meet, and that's a local group hosts that. But you know, with the Kingsport Aquatic Center, so that has really helped boost tourism. So when you think about cities building these facilities, upgrading ball fields, things like that, think long term about how we're going to be bringing in, you know, 100, 200 teams sometimes. Multiply that by how many kids are on a team, and then multiply that by, you know, parents, grandparents, and the impact is in the millions. So we've got that swim meet coming up. The 8 and under are is some of the categories. So, and then 15 and up. And so that's pretty neat coming up this weekend. We also have the Mid-South Conference Swimming Championship coming up February 2nd through 4th. I'll pull this off of Visit Kingsport's website. So that's more of the college, you know, the Mid-South Conference. That's a big deal. And then also coming up at Meadowview on February 18th and 19th is an AAU volleyball tournament, the Jewel of the Mountains tournament. So, you know, again, that's, you know, think about how many people are on a volleyball team and multiply that. And Washington and Sullivan County, they're both in the top 10 all out of all 95 counties in the entire state of Tennessee in terms of generating sales tax and revenue for us. So this keeps us, you know, keeps us going. And then also this weekend, because we consider cars kind of a sport.
Sure.
That's the 21st Automotive Swap Meet right across the street here at the Gray Fairgrounds. And it's $8 to get in going on this weekend. And if you're wanting to, you know, got that winter project, hooking your car up, things like that, fixer-upper, that's the place to go.
We're talking to Alicia Phelps. Again, we're live at Food City and Gray. Now, at the end of February, I know the Appalachian Athletic Conference has their tournament, both guys and girls basketball tournament, Meadowview. That brings the old tourism slogan, heads in beds, because they come, stay in the hotels, eat at our restaurants, stop by a Food City and get the snacks, what they need as a team, put gas in the vehicle. So it is far-reaching. And we've talked about folks about this before, even some teams come in town, summertime baseball teams, they take their clothes to the laundromats. You know, you never think about that.
I didn't even think about that. Yeah. I'm going to start using that.
Yeah, they take their uniform, particularly baseball, and they've slid in the bases and get all dirty, and they're staying in a hotel. They have no place to do their laundry, so they go and use our laundromats.
But they'll come here to Food City to get their detergent.
Soap powder.
And, you know, coming, I'm on this committee, the National Association of Indoor Track and Field Championships, or NAI conference. The championship event is coming up in City, March 2nd through 4th. Let's talk Olympics, because we will have some qualifying there. We will have some of the best athletes in the nation coming here, and it's going to be pretty awesome. So I'd love to get some of those folks involved to come chat with you. Maybe we'll go to the press conference, things like that. But that's going to be really fun. You know, if you've got kids that are interested in track and field, I remember when I was growing up, it was just awesome to go watch the ETSU basketball teams play back with Mr. Jennings and Rodney English and all them. So it was just so inspiring to see that. So it'll be fun, you know, for the locals to go see that as well. We'll have Milligan's competing too. So
also recreational sports. We don't think about this, but you have groups come in or individuals come in. And in the summertime, we're known for our fly fishing around the region. Then in the wintertime, when it snows up in the mountains, there's a lot of cross-country skiing goes on. So those kind of folks. And in the summertime, we have a lot of folks come in here and either ride motorcycles as a group or bicycles as a group, kayaking. So there's a lot of folks come in here that we think, gosh, and it adds up. 4 or 5 over here, or 6 or 7 here, or a group of 10 over here staying for 3 or 4 days. Again, putting heads in bed, spending that money, and it all goes to save us money, because when they come in and spend money, it cuts down on our taxes here, right?
It absolutely does. And, you know, you don't think about that. You think about the inconvenience of when we have these large events in town, and it's an inconvenience. But do you want to shout out, you know, $300 more in taxes? I think I'll take that. I'll take sitting in line and traffic or whatnot. But I will have a real exciting event coming up in the fall. Can't wait to talk about. So,
looking forward to it. Anything you got going on you want us to help promote, you let me know, because we're all about it here. So, Super Bowl, what do you think? Falcons or Patriots?
You know, I was Green Bay. So, go Falcons. They're a strong team, and they, you know, they just been in this position. So we'll see how it goes.
Yeah, it's pretty exciting. You know, Belichick has got 2 weeks to get ready against the Steelers, got him ready against Pittsburgh. But, you know, the old adage, I don't know how you can coach against speed, because the Falcons are so fast. I mean, that's what blows my mind. They are. Those running backs like you got shot out of a cannon. I've been saying it all week. So if anybody can beat Brady, and I don't know, you know, pretty tall task. But if anybody can, I think the speed of the Falcons may neutralize the Patriots some. But Belichick's going to have 2 weeks to get ready. The guy's a master, obviously, so should be a good one. And, again, as we've been saying, and we'll say it again next week, if you're looking for your snacks, here's the place to come, Food City. You get what you need to sit down and get ready for the Super Bowl next week. And I assume you're going to be somewhere watching it, aren't you?
I'll be somewhere. I don't know yet. I was just thinking, what am I doing?
Yeah, what are we doing for Super Bowl? There you go. There you go. Let me see. Are your hands any warmer?
No, because this door is constantly open with all these people coming in here for Midnight Magic.
She said when people come in, it looks like I'm proposing to you. So, will you?
I will.
Okay.
With the case of the water in the background.
Case of the water in the background. There you go. You might be a redneck if you propose with a case of water on the table behind you. So there you go. You're awesome. Thank you for stopping by here. And have a wonderful weekend. And say hello to Kev. And we'll talk to you soon, all right? Yep. Neat lady. Appreciate it. We'll take a quick break. We'll be right back. We go from the beauty to the beast. My man Crumb's in the house, the Tennessee Wildlife Resource Agency officer. As we go to the break, we want to, again, as promised, let you hear from Danica Patrick. You know, she's getting ready to start another season, Stuart Haas Racing. Question was posed to Danica Patrick, do you like the new format change that we've talked about? Obviously, Pat Patterson talked about it just a few minutes ago here on the show from the Performance Racing Network. So, as promised, here is Danica Patrick. Again, a question posed to her. Again, do you like the new format change? She had this to say on the Tom Daly Sports Show. I think it's going to be cool. There you go. That's Danica Patrick, the new format change. And then Austin, you know, Richard Childress Racing's been in a winless drought for a long time. They've not been bringing home any championships. So the question was posed to Austin Dillon. Has the winless drought affected the RCR organization, Richard Childress Racing? Austin Dillon had this to say about that here again on the Tom Daly Sports Show. I need to talk to you on the phone. Are you going to be around today?
Yeah, just give me a call on the new.
The new phone.
The other one is the Jonesboro.
Yeah. Cameo or whatever your name is, Water. Yeah. So, yeah. So I proposed to her. I can say I proposed to her.
No, he's proposing. You're going to propose to him?
No, I'm not proposing to him.
I don't think so.
I'm not holding his hand. But I proposed to you. I held your hand. I said, Will, you said yes, but I don't even know what I asked you, so.
I think you were asking me if you were going to buy me some potatoes and some cake there.
This doesn't work.
And that's what he's talking about each round. Again, talking about Richard Childress Racing again. Austin Dillon and Danica Patrick here on the Tom Daly Sports Show. Before we go to the break, we got Crumb coming up here in a few minutes. A couple of things I want to remind you. The Premier Protein Shakes, they're on sale today for Midnight Madness sale. Limit 4 for $3.99 for a 4-pack. Food Club Salad Dressing. Again, 99 cents a bottle, limit 4. Also, Keebler Vanilla Wafers, $1.99 a bunch, limit 4 again at Food City for the Midnight Madness sale. Sara Lee Bread, whole grain white Sara Lee Bread, 20-ounce loaf, limit 2 per person, $1.49. You know what, I'm going to come back tonight, and I'm going to rack up here after dinner this evening. Brim's Premium Popcorn, got it right down here, right in behind us. 18-ounce package for $2.99. Also, Fritos or Cheetos. Again, limit 4, $1.79 at your local Food City. This is at all Food Cities. Of course, we're here in Gray. Purnell's Sausage Patties, a 38-ounce box for $4.99 with the Food City Value Card. And then Pringles. Man, how many canisters of Pringles have I had in my lifetime? A ton. Pringles. We got Dale working for once. Here you go. Buy 3, save more for 99 cents. Again, Pringles. And also your soft drink special today, Coca-Cola 24-pack, 12-ounce cans, 2 for $10. And then Instant Oatmeal. Cold out there today, Instant Oatmeal, limit 4 for $1.99. Oatmeal's good for you, helps lower your cholesterol. Oatmeal's good for you in a lot of ways. And so they've got that on sale for $1.99 today, limit 4 per box. And then last but not least, Food Club Hot Cocoa. 99 cents a box, 8 to 10 packets to a box for 99.4 at your local Food City. Big Daddy Dell is going to join us coming up here in a few minutes. Up next, we have him right here. That would be my buddy from the Tennessee Wildlife Resource Agency officer, our dear friend David Crumb. And I'm going to ask him coming out of the break, and he's going to say, yes, there is, Tom. Are there people out there fishing today? He's going to say, yes, there is, Tom. There you go. Unbelievable. Quick break. We'll be right back. We'll be joined by David Crumb, Tennessee Wildlife Resource Agency officer, here on the Tom Daly Sports Show on AM 790 and also on Facebook Live. All right, folks, again, thank you. It's been a wild show. We love it. And so we want to say thank you. Monday we'll be at Bristol Orthotics and Prosthetics, broadcasting live there. Tuesday we're scheduled to be at Cherokee Barbershop. Wednesday will be at Champion Chevrolet. Wednesday will be at Chick-fil-A, I'm sorry. Thursday will be at Champion Chevrolet. And Friday at a Food City to be determined. So we do thank you very, very much. Again, go to our one-stop shop at TomTaylorSports.com. And again, go right there and like us and share us and like us, and you have been. And click on Listen Live to the radio station, 24/7. Charles Stanley coming up at the top of the hour. Doesn't get any better than Charles Stanley, although I like Eric Taxis a lot. That guy's good. I've been listening to him a lot in the afternoon. Eric Metaxas, very, very good show. Wall Builders, that's a good one too. All shows are good. In the mornings, we got our dear friend Ben Foy, our producer of this show, does the morning show and also does the general store. So leave it on that Listen Live button on my Facebook page, I mean my website page, I should say. And then also click on Facebook Live as well. Again, Wednesday show, we had 6,000 views on Wednesday show. So it is growing, needless to say, and we appreciate that. So hang in there. Coming out of this radio commercial timeout, we'll be joined by my man here from the TWRA. So we're talking fishing, poaching, what's our main topic?
We'll talk new license available on February 18th, and also TWRA is requesting public input for the hunting seasons. And we've got a potential new world record deer that was harvested in Sumner County.
Cool. There we go.
And we're talking about it.
Hey, Ben, how much time? You want me to set my timer? Go ahead, tell me how. Hang on here just a second. You said quick. That's the exact thing?
That's, yeah.
That's it?
That's it.
Just tell me when, Ben, I'll hit it. Okay, that'll work.
I don't like moving the car, but it's hard for us.
What?
Move your car, we need your parking place.
You really do. There are people parking everywhere out there. Absolutely.
I love it. All right, we'll talk about that. All right, stand by. Here we go. We're back with the Tom Taylor Sports Show, 23 before the hour. We're live here at 34 degrees. We're live at the Food and Grave with the Midnight Madness sale. All Food Cities enjoying this sale, and so are the shoppers, of course, at 106 stores across this great chain of Food City stores. We are joined by our buddy David Crum, the Tennessee Wildlife Resource Agency officer. Good afternoon, sir. How you doing?
Oh, I'm sorry. I was sitting here looking at the
Midnight Madness sale. There you go. Great sales going on the midnight tonight while supply has. So,
just fine. So, well, watching a snowflake or two fall outside. Some schools are already closing down at least early. Got a message from the auditor at 1 o'clock.
And she's at what system?
She's at Washington County system.
Washington County, Tennessee. Letting out at 1 o'clock. All right, there you go. Maybe get Ben to run those down for us in a minute back of the station. You can track down and read us off to us before we depart here in 22 minutes. All right, here we go. A deer harvest, world deer. I don't know if you can pull that picture back up, but go ahead and tell us about this. What county was it in? Put it up here on the camera, let's see if we can.
Sumner County, let's see if you can see a picture of that.
Wow.
That deer right there was harvested in Sumner County, Tennessee, and it is potentially, it's gone through the first stage to make it into the Boone and Crockett new world record. Measured at 307.58 inches. This one, Sumner County, 312.38 inches. That measurement, what they do is they come in, they calculate, they measure, they go along, they measure inches.
Right.
And this deer is 47 inches.
Wow, that's a big one.
This is
Is it a bow or a rifle? Bow or rifle got it?
Muzzle.
Muzzle loader?
Muzzle loader season.
Sumner County, where's that from here?
Sumner County will be over in northeast of Nashville.
Up near the Kentucky border, up in that area? Wow. Talking to our buddy again, Dave from Tennessee Wildlife Resource Agency. By the way, the season's out there right now to hunt. I've been doing my homework. OG is rabbit, also Wilson snipe, and squirrel. And there's one more. Quail. Rabbit season of February 28th, quail season of Feb 28th, and Wilson snipe to Feb
28th.
There you go. Yeah, I've been doing my homework. Kenwildlife.org. Well, then educate me. That's why we got you here. What'd I leave out?
Waterfowl.
Waterfowl.
Waterfowl season closes this Sunday.
Like day after tomorrow.
Yeah.
Okay. We're talking to our buddy David Crum, Tennessee Wildlife Resource Agency officer. Again, the officer's covering
10 counties.
Eight officers covering 10 counties. The website is tnwildlife.org. New license available coming up mid-February. Tell me about that, big guy.
New license are coming up February 18th. At least that's the
And so it goes available Feb 18th. Is that right? So there is a little bit of about 8 or 9 days of a carryover going from old to new, but you got to have it expire by the end of the month of February, right? Yeah. And so you sit down and plan, like, okay, sure, I'm going to squirrel, rabbit hunt, deer. I mean, so once you get on that website, tnwildlife.org, they can find out what they need to be, to be legal, quote unquote. Yeah. It is 17 before the hour. You mentioned waterfowl. What is still out there to be able to harvest till Sunday or through Sunday?
Well, waterfowl season, we've got ducks and geese.
Ducks and geese?
Ducks and geese. Yes. In fact, we're talking about seasons. We've got a quest for TWRA It's an opportunity for the public to provide the units and share concerns about hunting and regulations for TWRA staff. How many of you have been doing Wednesday, February 15th, public comment about the TWRA staff. Comments, committees submitted, email, email or this is
a lot of the specials, and of course there may be a threat I think our better chance of getting some light accumulation is Sunday night into Monday. So we've got flurries. Of course, that's here locally down the mountains. Obviously, it's going to be a better chance of getting some snow or some light accumulation. But again, they keep saying maybe an inch up there at best. So it's supposed to be 50s by Tuesday. So whatever we're going to get is not going to last very long. But I would think the traffic in here, in large part, because I got here at 11 and I watched it like at 10 to 12, the floodgates open. So I think it's midnight madness sale than it is weather sale. Because these are some great deals. I mean, I know right here behind us, they've already stocked it once, but the Scott paper towels and Scott bath tissues for $3.99. Anytime they put a limit, you know, it's a rock and roll special. They got a limit too per person. So, and I'm going to come by and get some of this spiral slice, whole or half. Make a good sandwich, a little cheese on it, and a little mayonnaise. Ooh, yeah. Make a bulldog break his chain, so right there, that'd be good stuff. So. Make a tadpole smack a whale. Here you go. All right, what went wrong? Steelers got beat. Was it Antonio Brown's off the field? Was it Roethlisberger having an off game? What went wrong with your Steelers against the Patriots? Yep. Huge.
He did come in and did real well. They were probably used to it. Williams came in. He did well. He did well for the touchdown. I haven't seen him hardly at all.
But he's not on bail.
But he's not there.
No, that's no mock on him. It's just the way it is. But Roethlisberger had a, you know, so-so game.
Yeah. Yes. But Antonio Brown is the whole hype about the big blow up against the Jordan Bengals. That was immature.
Not needed.
That was not needed.
No. Your backbreaker was, you get down there first and goal, and you can't punch it in. Got to settle for a field goal. That was a biggie. And then the flea flicker.
Touchdown that wasn't a touchdown.
Yeah.
That had to go back and end up having a didn't see that one.
No.
Didn't see that one.
Nor did the Steelers' defensive secondary saw it coming either. So.
I don't know. After watching part game of me as the first person got under the move around the answer, I don't know the Steelers' secondary.
No. No, it's
just, it was sad that when it comes down to the final and we're sitting on it. It ended up.
They didn't show up.
No.
Steelers didn't show up. Both games were blowouts.
Which I didn't think was going to happen. Allegedly, it's going to be a good game, but these last two were blowouts. You know, the Packers, to me, Crosby misses that field goal early. That kind of takes the wind out of their sails. And the guy fumbles the ball, fullback, goes into the end zone, touchback. Falcons go down, they score on an 80-yard drive. It's 17-0. Could have been 10-10. If they score there, field goal goes in, it's a 10-10 ball game. They go down 17-0. It's over, as far as I'm concerned. And so Packers never recovered. Made a showing, put 21 on the board, but so
they made a showing, but it wasn't the very end.
On paper, you would think going in it's gonna be a good ball game next Sunday, you would think. Patriots, Brady, everything going on with him, of course, he is who he is and they are who they are. Falcons with their team speed, you would think they can give him a game, but you know, at the end of the day, Belichick's got 2 weeks to get ready for these guys, and maybe I'm giving you too much credit, but you know, if you look at the Patriots, we've said this all week. You know, last year you were the star, then you're gone. They bring in Tom Taylor, he's gone. Ben Foy's there, he's gone. I mean, you look at Randy Moss, Wes Welker, go down the list, all these guys, the parts have been interchangeable over the years, and Tom Brady still. The guy last week, Chris Hogan, he'd been cut by three teams.
Mm-hmm.
He'd caught 12 career passes ever, and that was at Monmouth College, Monmouth University of New Jersey, where he played. And so the guy, you know, he comes on and Brady makes him a superstar.
yeah.
You know, and then, granted, the guy's got some talent, but...
Hang on a minute. The offensive line makes him a superstar.
Made Brady a superstar, yeah.
Made Brady a superstar, which in turn made him a superstar.
Because there was times in that game I was set when they'd snap the ball, and I would count. He'd get sometimes a four count. 1,001, 1,002, 1,003. I mean, you sit back there, and again, I'm not putting...
You give him 4, 5, 6 seconds.
He's going to pick you apart.
Yeah.
But anybody, well, and I'm not diminishing Tom Brady, but when you made a great point. When the offensive line gives that much coverage, I mean, that much protection, to give you a chance to find an open receiver, 9 times out of 10 in the NFL, you're going to find somebody out there running around.
Somebody open because they're out there scrambling. They realize if you're looking for something, they're out there trying to make you look good. You're out there trying to make them look good. You give them that much time to be trying to get open. Somebody's going to get open.
So does that diminish Tom Brady's talents? No, not at all. But
no.
It is what it is, and the Hogs protect him.
Not a big fan of Tom Brady, but he is a very talented, very gifted quarterback.
There you go. Appreciate you coming by, my friend. I know you got to get rolling. And so when the snow – I mean, do you get put on alert as an officer because it could be roads could get a little tricky? You have nothing to do with that, right, TWRA?
Depends on how bad the system is. There's a big major snow system coming in, and we end up getting blizzard,
and
yes, we
can
put on
the team. Yeah. Other than that, that's the case this weekend.
We've all got four-wheel
drive vehicles, emergency
vehicles,
so
we get put on alert if it's a really bad system that comes. I don't see that happening with this system.
No. I think we're okay.
I think I'll be just fine on this system.
50s by Tuesday. We're going to be okay. In fact, I looked at the extended forecast, and you're going to say, well, how can they predict into February? But I looked into mid-February, and we're talking 40s and 50s through mid-February. So maybe the wind will be a little mild, or we're going to get nailed by March. I don't know. But
it bothered me a bit. The problem is springtime, hate the bugs.
Yeah.
It's got to get cold for the bugs.
Yeah. I'll just buy some repellent.
You are a repellent.
There you go. I am a repellent. Yeah, I've been told that. Give me that hook, baby.
Remember, folks, the kids hooked on hunting and fishing, and don't have to worry as much about getting hooked on other things.
My dear friend David Crum, see you next week or whenever you can get back in. I know you're a busy man, so whenever you can get here, all right? Here's some taters. Appreciate him very much, my buddy David Crum, Tennessee Wildlife Resource Agency officer. We'll take a break. We'll run on college basketball from last night, the NBA. We got some other little tidbits to squeeze in 8 minutes, and we can do that. We'll do it the best we can. We'll be right back right after this. We're live in the city on the Midnight Madness sale, and it is hopping at this store, I can tell you that. Food City and Gray. It is rocking and rolling. We've got, 8 more minutes to go. We'll come right back and talk more about it. Sports here on the Tom Taylor Sports Show. Crumb's good now.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
He's good information.
I appreciate that.
We've done enough. We can ad lib it. So
we both have faces for radio, so we can talk and blah, blah.
No. Probably.
Well, we wouldn't know what to do if it was scripted. We'd mess it up.
I'm going to try and squeeze as much as it.
That's true.
Oh, gosh.
That's right.
I got a new sponsor. I got to talk with him.
He's over here siphoning right now, dude.
Got it. How much time am I going to have coming out of this break? I got 7 minutes. It's like.
Ben just got through saying he can't read.
We'll save all this stuff to Monday.
Ben, do me a favor. Next time Tom goes on air, be sure to remind him to wipe down the camera on his phone. Would you cut out all, see all that haze on there?
That would be the lighting. I think I'm going to be the...
No, that, part of that's got to do with the camera. You don't think so?
No, it says lighting.
Oh, okay.
No, it's glaring. That's why I lifted it up. See there? See there?
A little Q-tip, a little alcohol, maybe a little...
Now, watch this. See the glare of the lights?
Yeah.
See the difference? It makes it look like there's Vaseline on it. It's the lights, because it happens every time we come in here.
Maybe your camera's trying to make us look better.
Good luck on that.
It'll take more than that camera.
Good luck on that.
I don't know if an iPhone that's that talented. It has that kind of technology.
How much time?
15.
All right, I'm going to squeeze it as hard as I can squeeze and get it in there.
Thanks, Ben. Have a good one.
Tell him bye.
Thanks, Ben. Have a good one.
All right. Back on the Tom Taylor Sports Show. Got 6 minutes to squeeze it in. Here we go. See if we can go as fast as we can go. Major League Baseball All-Star Game is going to be awarded for 2019. We'll be going to the Cleveland Indians. This year it's going to be Marlins Park in Miami. Next year, the Nationals Park in Washington. Cleveland Indians Press Field 2019. Got a brand new sponsor. Hello there, Vicki Patterson. Hello, young lady. How are you? And again, we've got the glare of the lights here at Food City and Gray for the Midnight Madness. Tennis, Rafael Nadal will be taking on Roger Federer. Nadal against Federer for the Australian Open Tennis Championship. Again, Nadal is 23-11 head-to-head against Roger Federer and 6-2 in Grand Slam finals. Federer has not beaten Rafael Nadal in the major finals in Wimbledon in 2007, 10 years ago. So see if he can do it coming up here this weekend for the finals of the Australian Open. All right, college basketball from last night. Let's run them down for you. North Carolina beat Virginia Tech 91-72. You had the Battle of the Bragging Rights of Cincinnati. Cincinnati beat Xavier by 86-79 last night. Gonzaga stays undefeated at 21-0. They blew out San Diego by 36 last night. Arizona defeated Washington State by 17. Arizona 7th in the country. Trying to get everything in here. I got 4 minutes before we're out of here. Oregon goes on the road and beats Utah by 6, 10th-ranked Ducks. And St. Mary's with a 20-point win over San Francisco. St. Mary's, the Gales, are 21st-ranked in the country. That's the NBA last night. Thunder over the Mavs by 109-98. Russell Westbrook, 45 big ones for the Thunder. Pacers beat Minnesota by 6. Denver got by Phoenix, 127-120. Utah won by 8 over the Lakers. Again, that's all in the NBA. Tomorrow, college basketball. Also last night, the Lady Bucks get a big win. They win, who do they play? I'm trying, how did he get undropped it? Lady Bucks got a big win last night for Brittany Zell, and I apologize. Can I get it? Thank you, Lord. Furman, they beat Furman 74-64 for their third consecutive Southern Conference win. Tomorrow, we got a big basketball game at Freedom Hall. Place to be rocking. The Moccasins are coming to town. That's East Tennessee State's biggest rivalry. Chattanooga at Freedom Hall tomorrow night or tomorrow afternoon at 4 o'clock tip-off. And so the Bucks, and again, both are 6-2 in the league, half game behind UNC Greensboro. So the Bucks and the Moccasins play tomorrow, 4 o'clock, two old rivalries. And so it should be a barn burner at Freedom Hall. And so we get a chance to check that out. The place ought to be rocking. They're trying to do a fill-up Freedom Hall to get ready for the ball game coming up again tomorrow. Again, as we said, it's 4 o'clock at Freedom Hall in Johnson City. And then Duke's basketball coach, Mike Krzyzewski, says, guys, even though I'm hurt, I've had back surgery, I'm still watching you guys, and you're not getting it done. You're 2-3 in ACC play since he left for surgery. So he decided to discipline the players. Krzyzewski had a team meeting at his house earlier this week. He said, boys, get over here. We're going to feed you, and I'm going to chew on you. Coach K reportedly was not happy with the team, said, from here on out, they are banned from the Duke locker room from wearing any Duke apparel. He said, you will go back into the locker room when you start up to the standards of the Duke basketball program. How about that, Ben Foy? He said, you're not going to wear anything that says Duke. You're not going to be in the locker room. You start playing like a Duke basketball team. And so these guys, I guess, are dressing that. I guess they're dressing the PE locker room. I don't know where they're dressing, but he said, you start playing like a Duke team, I'll let you dress in the Duke locker room. So there you go. Got a brand new sponsor coming on board, and it's exciting. Today is our first day. We're going to talk more about them on Monday, but Phil's Dream Pit on Eastern Star Road. Woo! You can go in there and just smell the hickory smoke. That barbecue will set you free. Again, they make it every day, bring the barbecue fresh every day at Phil's Dream Pit. And the pulled pork is smoky and tender and juicy, and had some there the other night. And of course, the smoke just flying off of it. And I'll tell you what, you cannot beat the pulled pork at Phil's Dream Pit on Eastern Star Road there in Kingsport. Sliced beef brisket has a nice smoke ring to it. It's also juicy and tender. Put that on the plate and the steam's flying off of it. It is red hot. And man, it is good. And then you chase it with some of the side dishes they've got, which would include the fresh creamy coleslaw, potato and macaroni salad, and the hash brown casserole. And they got their own sauces too at Phil's Dream Pit. I'm a ninny, so I get the original sweet sauce. It's sweet yet mild. They got the sweet fire sauce, the smoking hot sauce, the blackberry sauce, the vinegar sauce out of North Carolina, and the classic South Carolina sauce, which is mustard-based. All that, again, available from Phil's Dream Pit. And, of course, they got takeout, and they do catering. So the phone phone number. They're open 6 days a week. Phone number is 349-6437 is the number to call. And again, I'm a huge, huge fan of Phil's Dream Fit. Love their pulled pork platter. In fact, I got one last night. Probably get one again today with the coleslaw and the hash browns. Get some of that sissy sauce, I call it, the original sweet sauce. Sweet yet mild. And it is good. It's all available again at Phil's Dream Fit. Right there off Eastern Star Road, a brand new sponsor here on the Tom Taylor Sports Show. Got more of those next week, too. We're excited about that. Ben, you, school closings, anything on the school closing you want to pass on to us? Okay. All right. I thought he said Washington County's letting out early, so Washington County, Tennessee is letting out at 1 o'clock is what David said. So that's because he's got a Well, we got 30 seconds, so we're going to have to step aside and go. So, hey, it's been a good show. We want to say thanks to our guests, Austin Dillon, Danica Patrick, Matt Patterson, also Doug Fritz, and Tammy and Dale from here at Food City, and, of course, David Crum, and our great producer extraordinaire, Ben Foy, back on front. We are out of time. We sincerely thank you for yours. Stay warm. Bye. Monday from Bristol Orthotics and Prosthetics in North Johnson City. We'll be there then with our next round of shows, and we'll see you then. Have a great weekend. It is WETB AM 790, Johnson Kingsport, Bristol. Charles Stanley coming up next here. Have a great weekend. It is 1 o'clock. So long with the Tom Taylor Sports Show. So that's why I got to get a tablet and get one this weekend. That way I can look because I know this. Yeah, well. Yeah, see. That's why I got to have a tablet here so I can get this reference stuff. Yeah. Well, I mentioned at one point, I said, Ben, won't you check for us? And you probably didn't. You didn't hear me. Okay, so that's where we'll be ahead of everybody else, but pumping out that stuff out. But that's all right. We'll get another chance to do it. So wow, got them all in. So I'm gonna box this up. He's telling me I gotta get out of here because I gotta open this register. So I gotta clean stuff up so I can get this seventh register on. So go on, Bubba. I'll holler at you. Thank you. Great job. All right, Facebook Live has been a crazy show. Thank you again very much, and we appreciate you. And again, go to our website at tomtaylorsports.com. You can like us and share us. Everything is there for you to click on. Listen live to this station. Listen live to Facebook when we're on. So, and like us and share us. We thank you for that. Have a great weekend. We'll do a sportscast tonight at 10 o'clock on our personal Facebook page, and then we will rejoin you Monday at 11 o'clock from Bristol Orthotics and Prosthetics in North Johnson City. Have a great weekend, and thanks so much for being a part of this show. Cannot thank you enough, wherever you are listening and watching. It's very, very gratifying for you to be a part of this. Thank you again, and again, have a great day.